This video is brought to you by Creative Market, the world's marketplace for design. Creators from around the world sell easy-to-use design assets, including templates, graphics, fonts, and a whole lot more that'll help your next creative project come to life. Check out their free goods of the week and many other high-quality assets by signing up at ilove.creativemarket.com/BLTV. Make sure to use this link so they know I sent you. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to easily create the look of invisible clothing. I provided this image of a remote highway and an image of a man wearing a white t-shirt. Their links are located in this video's description or project files. Feel free to use your own images if you like. To get the best effect, use an image of clothing that's white or light in color and has a lot of folds or creases. This'll amplify the effect. If you're using a subject wearing bright colored clothing, I'll show you how to change it to white or light gray in a few minutes. The first step is to separate the clothing and the body, and then place them each onto its own layer. To do this, open the Quick Selection tool. I find that a radius of 10 pixels generally works well for most sizes and resolutions. Make sure the Add To icon is active, which will add selections as you drag the tool over various parts of your subject. Drag your tool over just the clothing to select it. To check it, press Q on your keyboard. Then, revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the clothing onto its own layer. Make the subject active, and drag your tool over all the body parts. To remove areas of the selection that are outside the body, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over them. Then, cut and copy the body parts to its own layer. If your subject is wearing colored clothing, open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. When you click on each of the channels, red, green, and blue, you'll see that certain colors of your subject are very dark or very light, depending on how much of that color is picked up in that specific channel. In this particular image, if I want the red jacket to be the source of my displacement map, I'll use the red channel since this channel makes the jacket the lightest. Press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Click the RGB channel and open back your Layers panel. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste it above your subject. Now you'll be able to use the clothing for your displacement map. Shift-click the clothing to make it active as well, and press V to open your Move tool. Drag the two layers onto the tab of the background, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag them down and release. To move them, just drag them. To resize them, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you're using a Photoshop version earlier than CC 2019, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then, press Enter or Return. Next, we'll create a displacement map of the clothing which we'll use to displace or warp the background to give the illusion that it's wrapping itself around the contours of the clothing. Click the clothing layer to make it the only layer that's active, and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. We'll make a new layer below the copy by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. You can also go to Edit and Fill. Open the Contents list and click White. Shift-click the top layer to make it active as well, and merge the two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Desaturate it by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. Since displacement maps look best when they're blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian blur. Blur it 3 pixels. If you're using this particular image, let's bring out the midtones a bit more by pressing Ctrl or Command L to open your levels window. Go to the Input Midtones slider and drag it to the right to darken it. If you're using a different image, adjust its brightness accordingly. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop so you can find it easily. Name it Displacement and save it as a Photoshop PSD file. Click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Since we saved our displacement map to our desktop, we can trash this layer by dragging it to the trash can or, on later versions, pressing the Delete key. Ctrl-click or Command-click the eyeball icon next to the background to hide the other layers. We'll convert our background into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, make the background active and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Type in 30 for both scales and tick Stretch to Fit and Repeat Edge Pixels. Click the displacement file you saved onto your desktop and click Open. You'll notice two things that happen to the background. One, the area that takes the space of the clothing has warped itself to the contours of the folds of the clothing. And two, the background has moved up and to the left 30 pixels, creating a distortion on the bottom and on the right. We'll take care of the latter in a minute. Make the body layer visible, as well as the clothing layer. Make the clothing layer active and change its blend mode to multiply. Next, we'll get rid of the distortion along the edges by cropping them off. Open your rectangular marquee tool. Drag the tool just above the distortion at the lower right. Go to Image and Crop. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. If I've helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, or maybe even inspired you to explore your creativity, give back some love by joining my community of patrons at Patreon for as little as $2 a month. Click the Patreon card at the upper right or the link in my video's description. Thanks for watching.